Hello, how are you? Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And if it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, more than anything, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I can almost see that dream I'm dreaming. There's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. But I gotta keep trying, gotta keep my head held high. My wish for you is that this life becomes all that you want it to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you. Jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall. And hope when the crowd screams out, they're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you'll stay. It's always gonna be another mountain. Always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what is waiting on the other side. I did it all.
Crowd, you light up a room with the light that's inside you. Don't be afraid to let it out.
So hold your head up, don't let anybody get you down.
No one can do it just like you. Something magic in the way you move. You're original, you know it's true. Take your tune. You ain't got a single thing to prove. You're original, so just be you. Just be you. Just be you. Just be you.
You gotta believe you're here for a reason. This world needs somebody like you. 'Cause anybody can be a copy, and there will always be people talking. So face your fears and chase your dreams and dance like no one's watching.
No one can do it just like you. Something magic in the way you move.
One of a kind, a kind of once in a lifetime. Not just another face in the crowd.
No one can do it just like you. Something magic in the way you move. You're original, you know it's true. Don't let anybody take your tune. You ain't got a single thing to prove. You're original, so just be you.
Just be you. Just be you. Just be you. Close my eyes and I can see the world that's waiting up for me, that I call my own. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care, so call me crazy.
Brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams are keeping me awake. I think of what the world could be. A vision of the one I see. A million dreams is all it's gonna take. A million dreams for the world we're gonna make.
There's a house we can build. Every room inside is filled with things from far away. The special things I compile, each one there to make you smile on a rainy day.
They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say we've lost our minds. I don't care if they call us crazy. Run away to a world that we design.
Every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams are keeping me. Dreams with me. You may be right, you may be wrong, but say that you'll bring me along to the world you'll see, to the world I close my eyes to see. I close my eyes to see.
Every night I lie in bed, brightest colors fill my head.
A million dreams are keeping me alive.
A million dreams, a million dreams. I think of what the world could be. A vision of the one I see. A million dreams is all it's gonna take.
for the world we're gonna make. Every day I run a race, just trying to get ahead. Don't think about where I am now, just where I wanna be instead. I'm losing so much precious time, but will I be satisfied in the end? Oh, in the end.
I don't wanna spend my life trying to fight for what's not mine. I don't wanna lose myself in someone else's dream.
I know I was made with a purpose to reach past the surface, live life fearlessly. I want nothing less than to be who I'm meant to be.
Everyone is on their way, but I am standing still.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountain, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home, country roads. All my memories, they gather round her. Miner's lady, stranger to blue water. Dark and dusty, painted on the sky, misty taste of moonshine, teardrops in my eyes. Country roads, take me home to the
me. Radio reminds me of my home far away. Driving down the road, I've been feeling that I should have been home yesterday. Yesterday.
Mom. please remain standing. The BVHS Class of 2020 asks you to help us honor our nation's heroes, those that protect us, and those that have died trying to keep us safe. Today, we remember particularly those BVHS graduates currently serving our country. The colors today are presented by members of the Brandon VFW Post 4726 and Valley Springs American Legion Post 131. You are invited to join Abby Waldner as she leads us in our national anthem. Signing the anthem today are senior members of American Sign Language Class, Sydney Bonestrew, Alea Christensen, Ariah Halseth, Janelle Creer, and Jenna Viss. Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Graduates and guests, please be seated. Hello, my name is Cal Shackett, and joining me today on stage is our other graduation MC, Grace Wilford. We are honored to represent this great class. Family members and friends, thank you for coming today to celebrate the culmination of our high school years. On behalf of our classmates, we would like to officially welcome you to the commencement ceremony for the BVH Class of 2020.
Many members of our class are wearing white ribbons today in remembrance of parents, siblings, grandparents, other relatives, friends, and classmates who have passed away. Though they are not physically here today, their spirits will live on in our hearts. We believe that we honor the memory of those that are not with us today by celebrating life, and so today's graduation will continue the BVHS tradition of having fun at commencement.
We would like to take some special time to recognize the guests of the class of 2020 that will share the stage with us today. The Brandon Valley School Board members represent the communities that make up this school district. The support of these communities has given us the opportunity to receive outstanding education, and for that we are very thankful. Please join us in welcoming Board President Renee Ullum and members Ellie Saxer, Nick Scott, and Dr. Greg Talcott.
Also on stage are representatives of the Brandon Valley School District staff. The staff of the school district has left their mark on this class in so many ways, and we feel blessed to have them as a part of our lives. We have had so many great teachers throughout our years at Brandon Valley. It takes so many people to make a school district run well. We have been transported on buses, fed each day, had our injuries tended to, and had our messes cleaned up after us. We want to honor the work of all the staff of the district. Today, we are joined by Superintendent Dr. Jared Larson, Principal Mark Schleckaway, Associate Principal Bill Frecking, Associate Principal Randy Marceau, and school counselors Kara Lickness, Katie Murdy, and Michelle Stemwettle. Also in attendance are some of the teachers and staff members of Brandon Valley School District. We would ask at this time if you have taught any of us at any grade level, preschool through high school, including Sunday school, that you would stand and be recognized.
It is the tradition of Brandon Valley High School to have students speak at graduation. Our first speaker is Emily Hensley. During her years at BVHS, Emily has participated in marching band as a drum major, band, chorus, theater, National Honor Society, SAD, tattoo, and student council. Emily is a Regent Scholar, a recipient of the Presidential Award of Academic Excellence, and a highest honor graduate. Emily will be attending the University of South Dakota, where she is majoring in pre-law. Emily is the daughter of Mark and Christy Hensley. Classmates and guests, Emily Hensley.
Before I begin, I would like to first thank Mr. Schleckway, Mrs. Stemweddle, Mr. Brick, and Mr. Frecking for giving me the incredible opportunity to stand in front of you all today. On behalf of the class of 2020, I would also like to thank all the teachers and staff that made the transition to online learning as seamless as it was for students. I don't think it would be a stretch of anyone's imagination to say that we would not be here today had it not been for your dedication to our success and our education, so thank you. Last, I would also like to thank all the friends and family joining us this afternoon for the ceremony we weren't totally sure was going to happen among these unprecedented times. I can't speak on behalf of every household, but I do know having my own support system at home was absolutely crucial in making it to the end of the year, so thank you, parents and families. Throughout our lives, we're asked the question, what do you want to be when you grow up, over and over again? It usually starts around kindergarten, and because the world hadn't taught us to be anything but fearless yet, our answers were always a bit unrealistic. For me, I wanted to be a professional princess, and while my parents totally supported this idea, they also swiftly informed me how a monarchy works, and that the likelihood of finding someone with the title that wasn't 30 years older than me was very unlikely. I'd be lying to you all, though, if I said that deep down, becoming a princess still wasn't my dream, but I can say that I've grown up quite a bit since then, and my aspirations have changed exponentially. I think the same could be said for all of us here today. In this room are our future healthcare professionals, teachers, engineers, lawyers, business owners, mechanics, artists. And while it may be easy to answer the question, what do you want to be when you grow up, with whatever occupation you've chosen for yourself, I don't think it stops there, because we never really stop growing up. For so many, our identity lies in our jobs, but it's the other things we fill our time with that really defines who we are as people. Be an advocate for a social cause or charity. Be the friend that's always there to lend a shoulder or an ear. Be the person with the infectious laugh in a crowded room. Be an empathizer, be an ally. Whatever you choose, be more than your career. And when you decide what kind of person you want to be, don't stop there. Set your priorities in order and make the commitment to following them. Growing up doesn't always have to mean starting a new chapter in life, and it certainly doesn't just end when you graduate. If anything, growing up only begins when you decide what is actually essential in your life. And while looking ahead is always important, I'd be remiss if I didn't also warn you to not get so caught up in writing your future that you forget to appreciate the story right in front of you. Danish philosopher Søren Kierkegaard said, "Sometimes the most painful state of being is remembering the future." Seniors, appreciate the challenges you meet now, because there is no other present like today. Learn from your mistakes and grow from the structured box that high school has set upon you these past 4 years. Who you become after we leave today is all on you. And if at the end of the road, the person you see in the mirror isn't someone you like, there will be no one to blame. Work hard to be successful, but work even harder to be proud of the person you are today and the person you will become tomorrow. Congratulations, seniors, you've done well. I leave you, class of 2020, and all those celebrating with us today, with the challenge to ask yourself, not what you want to be, but rather who you want to be when you grow up. Thank you, and congratulations again.
Brandon Valley High School has a reputation for excellence in the classroom, on the field, court, track, and stage. Today we have the opportunity to hear from some of the senior members of the Concert and Lynx Choirs perform Bridge Over Troubled Water by Paul Simon. We want to thank this dedicated group of 17 seniors for spending time over the past month practicing and recording their performance for today's ceremony. Garrett Lean, one of our senior voices in the performance, could not be in attendance today as he is currently serving our nation in the U.S. Army. Leading the senior choir members is one last performance is our director, Terry Gullickson.
I'll be your bridge, oh troubled water.
When you're down,
I will carry you like a bridge, oh troubled water. I will lay me down. Tears are in your eyes, I will try.
Troubled water, I will lay me down.
Next, we have two speakers that often feel like one person to the class of 2020, Harry and Henry Heiberger. During their years at BVHS, they participated in wind ensemble, marching band, jazz band, chamber orchestra, spring musical pit orchestra, salsa, tri-M, quiz bowl, and Mu Alpha Theta. Harry and Henry are both Regent Scholars, recipients of the Presidential Award of Academic Excellence, National Merit Scholars, and Highest Honor Graduates. Harry and Henry will be attending MIT in the fall and will both major in electrical and computer engineering. Harry and Henry are the sons of Thomas and Jane Heiberger. Classmates and guests, Harry and Henry Heiberger.
Thank you, Mr. Schleckaway, faculty and administration, fellow graduates, family, and friends for providing us with the amazing opportunity to speak before you today. It has been an honor to be a part of the Brandon Valley High School class of 2020, and we have loved every minute of the last 13 years we have spent in this district. Each and every one of you has certainly made an impact on our lives and formed memories that will last far into the future.
American writer Mark Twain once said, 20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things that you didn't do than by the ones you did. Thus, we are proud to say that we have certainly been in a class that has done a lot. Throughout our time in high school, we have all accomplished great feats and pushed ourselves to become the best people we can be. In academics, we set the bar far higher than ever before, with test scores, dual enrollment participation, and classroom engagement all at record highs. In sports, our teams emerged from a historic trifecta with yet another year of success and state competition. In the arts, our band wowed thousands in performances that rivaled those of professionals. Our orchestra expanded into two groups, and our theater department rose to the best in its class. Most importantly, our class has proven to be passionate volunteers, spearheading efforts in organizations such as Salsa, Tri-M, and Mu Alpha Theta. To put it plainly, how many groups of teenagers would choose to help clean up flooding in the neighborhood when they could have more easily gone home? This determination to do more than what is expected has made it so that, whether it be on the field or the stage, in the classroom, or even just in Brandon, our class has left a huge impact.
However, if 2020 has taught us anything, things never go as expected. We entered the school year just like any other, ready for a second semester with our friends and classmates. We were excited for spring sports, prom, and typical graduation festivities. Yet, as the year progressed, life had other plans. During the period when we all hoped to be spending our last few months together, classes were forced online, events were canceled, and the way we knew the world was turned upside down. But one must never forget that we are the class of 2020. We graduate in a century that is still in its infancy, at a time in history when our world is dealing with enormous challenges. From the coronavirus pandemic and ecological disasters to economic turbulence and social tensions, our struggles are undeniable. Yet, we are at a time when the opportunities to remedy these challenges have never been greater. We are technology natives, born and educated in a technological world that used to be found only in science fiction. We Twitter and tweet, read books and news online, communicate with people thousands of miles away, and travel across the world in mere hours. We are the generation that will take the technology of today to new and dizzying dimensions. We are the ones who will bring solutions to many of the problems plaguing the 21st century. Our lives may have only just begun, but we are the future and will shape generations to come.
Presently, we are gathered at the gateway to a new chapter of our lives, armed with the skills and knowledge obtained from our amazing teachers and mentors. For some, college or technical school will be your next journey. Others will be heading straight into the workforce. And some have selflessly chosen to serve in our nation's military. Whatever direction you take, we guarantee that each and every one of you will leave an impact on the world around you, a contribution to the great landscape of life that will be determined by how you set your goals and follow your dreams. This has already been proven by the way the class of 2020 has done amazing things. However, all of our hard work and determination would be for nothing if we stop here.
While today we celebrate our past activities and accomplishments, we want to challenge all of you to continue to take full advantage of every opportunity that life presents. Yes, there will be times when you feel like you do not want to complete another interview. And yes, there will be times when you feel like you have no chance of receiving a job, award, or promotion. However, by never stopping in your pursuit of self-betterment, it is possible to achieve unimaginable things. Whether it be by learning a new skill or hobby, helping others in the community, or furthering your professional goals, the possibilities are endless. In the end, only when you are certain that you are making the most of the opportunities available to you are you able to live life regret-free.
In closing, as you go forward in your lives, remember to not forget your friends, teachers, and classmates that have made you who you are today. True friendship is a treasure that you will always cherish.
Continue to care. Care about your family, your friends, your community, and most importantly, yourself.
And finally, whatever path you decide to take in life, make sure the journey includes joy.
Thank you for all of the amazing memories over the years.
It has been our pleasure to learn alongside you for the past decade.
We can't wait to see the amazing things each of you will accomplish.
So, once again, to everyone who has helped us get to where we are today, thank you.
Time has come for us to cross the stage and be presented with our diplomas. It is Brandon Valley High School graduation tradition to have fun at graduation to celebrate the accomplishments of the graduate.
You are encouraged to do whatever your family does to celebrate. We only ask that after your graduate has received their diploma, that you let the next family have the opportunity to celebrate their graduate in their own style.
Dr. Larson, members of the school board, Mr. Schleckaway, Mr. Frecking, Mr. Marceau, members of the school district staff, family, and friends, we have met the requirements set forth by the state of South Dakota and the Brandon Valley School District and ask permission to take the stage one last time as BVHS students.
Graduating with highest honors, Teresa Ossing. Aiden Achimilye. John Henry Ackerman. Maya Eichley. Graduating with highest honors, Madison Albertson. Matthew Anderson. Tara Anderson. Trevor Anderson. Woo! Graduating with highest honors, Toshlyn Badger. Rain Bakken. Graduating with highest honors, Alexis Banworth. Blake Barber. Graduating with highest honors, Ryan Barker. Graduating with highest honors, Abigail Bastian. Graduating with honors, Hannah Behrens. Zachary Bennett. Graduating with honors, Brooklyn Berry. Anthony Bertrand. Graduating with highest honors, Keaton Beyer. Joshua Biber. Micah Bickler. John Todd Bieber. Samuel Bearn. Graduating with highest honors, Brooke Bishop LaFrance. Graduating with highest honors, Jessica Blakowski. Alex Blum. Reagan Bly. Sydney Bonestro. Graduating with highest honors, Elizabeth Boomsma. Carter Borkhart. Horizon Bosch. Yeah. Tyler Bronner. Graduating virtually, Alana Breckis. Adam Brocky. Allison Bruce. Graduating with highest honors, Jackson Bruggeman. Isaac Bullis Rodriguez. Elizabeth Byrie. Brett Cady. Graduating virtually, William Campbell. Graduating with highest honors, Ava Carone. Graduating with high honors, Eli Cheever. Michael Chevalier. Alea Christensen. Kendra Christofferson. Matthew Clark. Graduating with honors, Taylor Klein. Jacob Klo. Graduating with highest honors, Alexandria Davis. Graduating with highest honors, Peyton DeYoung. Graduating virtually, Brandon Dossett. Gracelyn Doherty. Graduating with honors, Braden Dibdahl. Corwin Dykstra. Ethan Ebersbacher. Amanda Eichelberg. Coulter Elkin. Graduating with highest honors, Abby Erkonen. Graduating virtually, Isabel Evans. Hope Barsdale. Graduating with honors, Kylie Felderman. Jamie Fick. Graduating with highest honors, Caitlin Fletcher. Allie Foss. Graduating with highest honors, Riley Franz. Graduating with highest honors, Shelby Frey. Hannah Frost. Christopher Gascoigne. Quinn Gienapp. Graduating with highest honors, Brooke Gayden. Yashari Graber. Emma Groenwald. Graduating with highest honors, Grant Gunderson. Robert Gunnick. Braden Gilling.
Wyatt Haas. Jackson Hayes. Alexandria Hamner. Graduating with honors, Grace Hansen. Sierra Harris. Taylor Haug. Graduating with highest honors, Ethan Haig. Graduating with highest honors, Harry Heiberger. Graduating with highest honors, Henry Heiberger. Araya Helseth. Miles Himmelstrand. Helena Hendrick. Graduating with highest honors, Emily Hensley. Graduating with highest honors, Zach Henschel. Corinne Herding. Graduating with high honors and currently serving our country, Luke Higgins. Graduating with highest honors, Catherine Hinsman. Graduating with honors, Jimmy Hoffman. Caleb Holm. Graduating with highest honors, Nathan Holm. Colton Hood. Graduating with honors, Macy Horner. Ethan House. Cole Hupke. Graduating with honors, Hannah Jackman. Samantha Jansen. Isaac Yajumpchek. Graduating with highest honors, Lucas Johnson. Max Johnson. Graduating with high honors, Olivia Jones. Josh Jupiter. Brad Kalla. Breetu Kadir. Currently serving our country, Keely Keelman. Alyssa King. Graduating with highest honors, Ethan Jensted. Caleb Kiergaard. Currently serving our country, Caleb Collette. Graduating with high honors, Elijah Klein. Connor Klemick. Graduating with highest honors, Elizabeth Clune. Madison Coburnus. Graduating with highest honors, Callista Kutzmick. Taylor Cons. Janelle Creer. Graduating with highest honors, Jessica Krogman. Macklin Lobbs. Graduating virtually, Jackson Labrie. Graduating with high honors, Brianna Langenhorst. Titan Larson. Yeah. Graduating with high honors, Madison Lawrence. Logan Levitt. Jack Lee. Janet Lee. Tana Layfelt. Samuel Lemke. Currently serving our country, Garrett Lean. Caden Ling. Morgan Livesay. Graduating with highest honors, Kate Livingston. Ashley Lohr. Graduating with highest honors, Jenna Long. Graduating with highest honors, Santos Adonis Lopez Bonilla. Macy Mayers. Casey Maxim. Emily Mangmoradeth. Graduating with highest honors, Hunter Marceau. Graduating with highest honors, Mason Mattis. Ty McCann. Ethan McEachran. Olivia McElravy. Darius McKinstry. Ethan McManus. Hunter Meinert. Molly Melmer. Graduating virtually, Landon Merkel. Mackenzie Metzger. Megan Meyer. Courtney Moeller. Colby Montoya. Graduating with highest honors, Emily Muse. Aiden Mushinovic. Graduating with highest honors, Avery Myers. Marcus Nace. Dylan Nath. Kalia Nelson. Isaiah Navy. Caden Nichols. Braden Nischel. Madison Knowles.
Shane Ogden. Ashley Olson. Cecilia Paulson. Graduating virtually, Sydney Peltier. Graduating with highest honors, Brianna Peterson. Graduating with highest honors, Heidi Peterson. Graduating with high honors, Dane Payton. Graduating with highest honors, Megan Pickering. Riley Pletton. Cassidy Poole. Cheyenne Radford. Graduating virtually, Lawrence Rasmussen. Graduating with highest honors, Alyssa Reinschmidt. Brittany Ryder. Victoria Rice. Nicholas Roby. Zach Rogo. Gavin Rowell. Timothy Ruhoff. Ty Sano. Graduating with honors, Mara Scott. Graduating with honors, Keith Schenkel. Graduating with highest honors, Thomas Skolton. Riley Schroeder. Graduating with honors, Calvin Shackett. Brooke Shriver. Graduating with highest honors, Ella Simonson. Braden Scow. Desiree Skyberg Hill. Jack Smith. Caleb Smith. Christopher Smith. Graduating with highest honors, Landon Smith. Jeremy Summer. Hannah Sorensen. Graduating with highest honors, Jory Sorensen. Nicholas Steffler. Graduating with highest honors, Caden Stanger. Graduating virtually, Jesse Stuffel. War Steven. Amber Story. Emily Stroud. Austin Swenson. Samuel Switzenberg. Graduating with highest honors, Cole Seelison. Graduating with highest honors, Gavin Terhart. Kobe Terpstra. Blake Trevere. Daryl Terwilliger. Amanda Tews. Blake Thompson. Rachel Thompson. Avery Timmons. Graduating with highest honors, Cade Tripp. Graduating with highest honors, Tucker Trout. Cody Yukin. Jesse Van Hemert. Graduating with high honors, Sophia Van Horn. Graduating with highest honors, Kira Van Rokel. Jared Vanderbush. Graduating with high honors, Brett Van Oort. Haley Vilgersdijk. Graduating with highest honors, Katie Vest. Graduating virtually and with high honors, Daisy Viss. Jenna Viss. Graduating with honors, Abby Waldner. Leslie Warren. Rosemary Washnack. Kayla Watkins. Parker Webb. Graduating with high honors, Emily Wendt. Riley White. Graduating with honors, Michaela Wickman. Morgan Weaker. Graduating with highest honors, Grace Wilford. Braden Wills. Graduating with highest honors, Benjamin Waidula. Graduating virtually, Fiona Wooten. Graduating with highest honors, Ethan Wright. Brian Winia.
Graduates, I've spent a lot of time over the last few weeks and even months thinking about my last words and advice to all of you, especially during these uncertain times. March 13th, 2020 is a day that's been etched in my brain, and I don't think I'll forget it anytime soon. That was the last normal school day that we got to spend together your senior year. Since this day, we've all experienced emotions that include fear, anxiety, confusion, and disappointment, to name a few. It's also safe to say that we've all had multiple challenges to overcome. I hope you understand that challenges in life are important. I'm a big believer that challenges provide us an opportunity of amazing personal growth. We may not always think that while we're going through it at the time, but in the end, we end up right where we belong. Today, I want to talk briefly on a personal challenge I experienced in my life. It was January of 2008, and this was another one of those days that have been etched in my brain. My wife, Julia, was expecting at the time, and we found out some news that stopped us in our tracks. The doctors told us they were concerned about the baby's heart and that there was a chance that the baby could be born with Down syndrome. To be completely honest, I was feeling some of those emotions that I mentioned earlier: fear, anxiety, confusion, and if I'm being completely honest, a little disappointment, but just for a little while. I think it was the fear of just the unknown of what was going to be next. Then came June 17th, 2008. Griffin was born, and we hit the road running one day at a time on a journey that has simply been amazing. My wife and I entered this journey, and we said we were going to have a positive attitude, gratitude towards the little things in life, and we vowed to enjoy the journey and not focus on the destination. This was a journey that started with fear, but one that ended with me being in front of you today. See, Griffin changed my way of thinking and what I wanted to do with my career. She showed me the power of treating everyone with respect and that we all bring amazing gifts to the world. In the end, I ended up right where I belonged. When all of us in this room embarked on the journey this year, none of us could imagine the road we would have to travel. This was a road that didn't have GPS, didn't have Google Maps, and didn't have a playbook for any of us to follow. This road became a journey that we were all in together. And although this may be difficult to completely understand at this very moment, in the end, this became a journey that's going to serve you well as you enter the next stages of your life. So let's talk a little bit about a couple lessons that I hope you learned on this little journey together. Gratitude. Being grateful for the little things in life, like going to the movie with friends, giving a grandparent a hug, having a graduation party, or having an in-person ceremony like today. Living life with a grateful heart allows you to enjoy and appreciate the journey. Perseverance. You learn to persevere when times got tough. You continued your senior year of classes from home, even though you would have given anything to be in class with your friends and teachers. You lost spring activities and senior end of the year events like prom and May graduation. Yet you all found ways to stay connected with each other, and in the end, you grew closer with your friends and your family. Years down the road, when life throws you a curveball, continue to persevere. In closing, I want to read a few lines from a poem by Robert Frost, The Road Not Taken. Two roads diverge in a wood and I took the one less traveled by, and that made all the difference. The class of 2020 has taken the road less traveled. You are stronger today because of the road you had to take. This class is special to me for a lot of reasons. We've been through a lot together. Today means more than me to me than any words can describe, and all of us sitting here with you are grateful to be here with you. I hope when you look back at high school, you remember not what was taken from you your senior year. I hope you remember how great the journey was together. I assure all of you that this is not goodbye.
I can see it in your eyes that you are restless. The time has come for you to leave. It's so hard to let you go, but in this life I know you have to be who you were made to be. As you step out on the road, I'll say a prayer, so that in my heart you always will be there. This is not goodbye, I know we'll meet again, so let your life begin, 'cause this is not goodbye. It's just I love you to take with you until you're home again. The stirring in your soul has left you wondering, should you stay or turn around? Well, just remember that your dreams, they are a promise, that you were made to change the world. So don't let fear stop you now, 'cause this is not goodbye, I know we'll meet again, so let your life begin. Just I love you to take with you until you're home again. Oh, I know the brightest star above was created by the one who loved more than we'll ever know, to guide you when you're lost. What started as a still small voice is raging now, and your only choice is to follow who you are. So follow who you are, 'cause this is not goodbye, I know we'll meet again. Oh, this is not. Just I love you to take with you until you're home. It is I love you to take with you until you're home. It is I love you to take with you until you're home again.
Graduates, please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, the Brandon Valley High School Class of 2020.